When comparing mobile communication systems that use microwave transmission versus those that use satellite communication, it is important to understand the strengths and weaknesses of each technology. The better option depends on the specific use case, such as the location, required coverage, latency, and cost considerations. Below is a clear differentiation between the two. 1. Mobile communication using microwave transmission. How it works. Microwave-based mobile communication relies on a network of ground-based microwave towers and antennas to transmit signals between mobile devices and the core network. These towers are connected in a line of sight, LOS, manner, and signals are relayed from one tower to another. Key features. Line of sight, LOS, requires a clear path between towers. Short to medium range, suitable for urban and suburban areas. Low latency, signals travel at the speed of light over short distances. High bandwidth, supports high data rates for mobile internet and voice calls. Advantages. Low latency, ideal for real-time communication like voice calls and video streaming. High data speeds, supports 4G, 5G, and other high-speed mobile networks. Cost-effective, cheaper to deploy in densely populated areas. Reliability, works well in urban environments with minimal obstructions. Disadvantages. Limited coverage, requires frequent towers and repeaters, not suitable for remote or rural areas. Line of sight dependency, obstacles like buildings, mountains, or trees can block signals. Weather sensitivity, signal quality can degrade during heavy rain or storms. Best use cases. Urban and suburban areas with high population density. Applications requiring low latency and high bandwidth, for example, video calls, online gaming. 2. Mobile communication using satellite communication. How it works. Satellite-based mobile communication uses artificial satellites orbiting the Earth to relay signals between mobile devices and ground stations. The mobile device communicates with the satellite, which then transmits the signal to a ground station connected to the core network. Key features. Global coverage, works in remote, rural, and oceanic areas where ground infrastructure is unavailable. High latency, signals must travel to space and back, causing delays. Lower bandwidth, typically offers lower data speeds compared to microwave systems. No line of sight dependency, works even in areas with obstructions. Advantages. Global reach, provides connectivity in remote, rural, and disaster-stricken areas. No ground infrastructure, does not require towers or repeaters on the ground. Reliability in remote areas, ideal for maritime, aviation, and wilderness communication. Disadvantages. High latency, not suitable for real-time applications like gaming or video calls. Lower data speeds, limited bandwidth compared to microwave systems. Expensive, high setup and operational costs for satellites and ground stations. Weather sensitivity, signals can be affected by atmospheric conditions. Best use cases. Remote and rural areas with no ground infrastructure. Maritime and aviation communication. Emergency and disaster recovery operations. When comparing microwave-based mobile communication and satellite-based mobile communication, it is essential to consider their coverage, latency, data speeds, cost, infrastructure requirements, line of sight dependency, and weather sensitivity. Microwave-based systems excel in urban and suburban areas, offering low latency and high data speeds, making them ideal for real-time applications like video calls and online gaming. They rely on ground-based towers and repeaters, which are cost-effective in densely populated regions but require a clear line of sight and can be affected by heavy rain or storms. On the other hand, satellite-based systems provide global coverage, including remote and rural areas, without the need for ground infrastructure. However, they suffer from high latency due to the long-distance signals must travel to and from satellites, and they offer lower data speeds compared to microwave systems. Additionally, satellite communication is more expensive due to the costs associated with launching and maintaining satellites, and it can be affected by atmospheric conditions. In summary, Microwave-based communication is better suited for urban areas with high data demands, while satellite-based communication is indispensable for global connectivity and remote regions where ground infrastructure is impractical. Both technologies serve complementary roles in ensuring seamless communication worldwide. Which is better? For urban and suburban areas. Microwave-based mobile communication is better due to its low latency, high data speeds, and cost-effectiveness. It is ideal for densely populated areas where ground infrastructure is feasible. For remote and rural areas. Satellite-based mobile communication is better because it provides global coverage without the need for ground infrastructure. It is the only viable option for areas where building towers is impractical or impossible. For real-time applications. Microwave-based systems are superior for applications like video calls, online gaming, and streaming due to their low latency. For emergency and global connectivity. Satellite-based systems are indispensable for emergency communication, maritime, aviation, and connecting remote regions. Conclusion. The choice between microwave-based and satellite-based mobile communication depends on the specific requirements of the user or application. Microwave systems are better suited for urban areas with high data demands and low latency requirements, while satellite systems are essential for global coverage and remote connectivity. Both technologies complement each other and are often used together to provide seamless communication worldwide.